Easter.
Hallelujah.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. As we continue our Easter journey, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. Therefore, I ask you, do you renounce Satan, all his works, and his empty show? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, just a second, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace for eternal life. In Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Thank you.
us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, Jesus stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then Jesus said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as Jesus said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, Jesus asked them, "Have you here anything to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. And he took it and ate it in front of them. Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all nations beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia.
If some students still have their mass ticket for today, please bring it over. This is your last chance, okay? Thank you. Very good. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. I'm so proud of these kids. They make their best effort to come to Mass, unlike previous years. So now we know that you are here at Mass, when you are here, of course. That's great. Let's give our students a big hand. They deserve it. Happy Easter. We welcome you to this Holy Mass, and we welcome the more than 60 families that celebrate this Mass online. If there is something that the Lord is good at, it's at waiting and patiently waiting. If we see in the recollection of today's Gospel, the Lord appears to them. He had appeared before and before, at least two other times in the Gospel of Luke, but his disciples don't seem to understand what's going on, right? And so the Lord, instead of chastising them, punishing them, etc., what he does is that he explains to them again and again. He had just made the explaining before as they were, these disciples that were going to Emmaus. If you remember that story, Jesus approached them, explained to them, then he opened his eyes so that he could recognize him because they could not see Jesus in him. It's the same thing he did today. In the Gospel of today, we're told that just as the other disciples that were going to Emmaus returned to Jerusalem to tell the others, and the others were in kind of disbelief, he comes at the same room and explains the same story again. These things had to happen so that everything would be fulfilled and then salvation would be brought about in his person. Over and over and over again, he has to do it. And it is only towards the very end, that even though they don't seem to fully understand what's going on, he commissions them to go and preach to all the nations. He said in today's gospel, he says, starting from Jerusalem, meaning salvation is going to come from Jerusalem into the whole world. And that's how you and I have been touched by this salvation, because somebody made the decision to finally believe into what Jesus had said and go about doing what he had asked. That implies a journey. At the beginning of the gospel, we hear on the way, on the way. And the way is not just a way, you know, of course it is a way, but on the way in the Gospel of Luke also means on the journey. As we try to understand Jesus, as we walk with him, a journey is not just a path, but the path actually is Jesus himself. And so on the way is that Jesus finds them, on the way is that Jesus calls them, on the way is that Jesus explains to them, on the way is where Jesus eats with them, on the way is everything that happens in the life of Jesus. And it is on that same way that the disciples over and over and over again do not seem to understand. At the beginning, they were kind of elated that Jesus would have chosen them. Why not? But then as Jesus started explaining his life, they were kind of looking for the best place, if you remember that, right? If you're going to be crowned king, I want to be at least a governor. I want to be a prefect. I want to be seated next on your right or on your left. They would not understand. At some points, the disciples were just having these fights against each other. Who was the most important and who was able to do more miracles than the other, if you remember the stories? But Jesus doesn't give up on them. Why so? This is the story, right? In a nutshell, the reason why I'm here is because somebody has had patience with me. I can number a bunch of people, so many people in my life that have been very patient with me. But I'm going to name just certain groups. My family, of course, my mom and my dad at the top of the list, right? They had to put up with me when I was growing up, and even to this day, right? But especially when I was growing up, you think I was as holy as I look now, you're very much wrong. I was just as many of your kids are, just as they are. But I was trying to find something in life, and so that's why I entered in the seminary. And when I was in the seminary, I made several mistakes. When I was a postulant, when I was a novice, and then when I was a student studying philosophy, and then I left and they let me go, and then I came back and they let me back in, and then I continued making mistakes. They have been very patient with me. In my life, in the Diocese of Austin, the bishop has been very patient with me. Of course, he doesn't have to exercise, I hope and pray that he doesn't have to exercise the same patience for me now that I am a priest than when I was younger and even a teenager or even a kid. I hope that he doesn't have to put up with that much. But I'm sure at times he just has to be patient with me. Just like that, Jesus shows us his love by way of being patient with us, explaining again and again. Even when people don't seem to understand, he does not chastise, he does not punish, he does not beat, he doesn't do any of that. He is always ready to explain the reason of things and why things should move on one or another direction. Why do I say this? Well, I say this because at times there are parents that approach me and tell me, share their experience with me about their children or grandchildren not going to church, their children or grandchildren not practicing the faith or even rejecting the faith. And this is what I always say. First of all, and of course they say, I can't force them to come to church because now they are adults. And of course, nobody wants to be forced to come into church, right? Even the kids that bring their religious education mass ticket every Sunday and every time they have to bring it, of course it is an obligation, but it is an obligation that we hope that comes from wanting to understand the faith and the love of the church, because that's what we are teaching them. We're teaching them the faith, and that's why it is important, the mass ticket is important, because it's not about the ticket, it is about the frequency of visiting with God in his house and worshiping together. We can do the prayers at home, and in fact, many of us pray at home, and that's fine, but worshiping together is important. And so they make the greatest effort to leave whatever they were doing this morning, meaning nothing. And then they come into church to do something, right? To do something important, to learn about the faith. That's what you guys are doing here as students in religious education. Well, God is patiently waiting for us all the time, giving us one more time, a second chance and a third chance and one more chance, etc., so that we may understand and one day soon, go out and preach Jesus' name. When parents come and tell me about their children not wanting to come to Mass because they are adults and all that, the one thing that I say is, the first question I ask is, did you plant any good seed in them as they were growing up? When they were babies, when they were growing up, when they were teenagers, when you had basically something to do for them, did you plant good seeds in them? The great majority of parents tell me, yes, we did. But now they don't practice. And I'm like, just stop there. If you planted good seeds, make sure that through your prayers, these seeds that today seem to be just buried there, one day they're going to break open and flourish. Because that's what Jesus does with us. He gives us the seeds. He plants seeds in us. And at times those seeds, my goodness, they break open and they flourish like in a week or so. But most times, and it is my case, it takes years for these seeds to break open and flourish. So I am saying, don't give up. Because if you planted some good seeds in your children, right, those seeds are going to break open at some point in life. And it doesn't depend on them. It depends on God and when he calls them and when they are willing to listen to what he's got to say. Now, there are some parents, just a handful of parents at times that tell me, no, I didn't plant good seeds. I didn't know about God. I didn't know about religion. I didn't know about the church. I did not plant seeds in them. Then I say exactly the same thing. You didn't plant seeds? Okay. But now you're living a God life? right? And the Lord has been patient with you. Now you are to be patient, exercise patience with those around you. And if you did not plant seeds, ask God to plant some good seeds in them so that one day they can see and experience what you see and experience and live under the shadow of the Lord, who is always, always patient and wants to embrace us with his love and with his mercy. So whether you planted good seeds in people or didn't have the chance, right? Maybe at that time, you know, sometimes people go through addictions and everything is important, but church is not important. God is not on the picture. If you planted great seeds, they're going to flourish at one point and you're going to be amazed. If you get to see that, you're going to be amazed at the seeds that you planted and what God can do with those seeds. But if you did not get a chance to plant good seeds because you were busy doing other things, whatever you might have been doing, ask God to plant good seeds in those hearts, because he is always, always patient. And as we are on the way as in the church, on the way to heaven, ask the Lord to plant good seeds in your children, in the people you love, in your friends, in people that are important to you, that are, they are amazing people. They just don't practice their faith. Don't you know people like that? Say amen if you do. There's great people sometimes, but they just don't practice their faith. And faith is important to us. So let us make this commitment, today, that we are going to pray for those whose seeds seem to be dormant, that one day soon they may open up and flourish. And for those who do not have seeds, we're going to pray even harder so that the seeds that you did not plant, that we did not plant, that God with his power may plant in them, and that these seeds at some point in their lives, they may break open and flourish. Not so that we may test God, but to show actually the glory of God. Amen? Happy Easter. Since we have already professed our faith, let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
Let us pray for the church, for ourselves, that we may be witnesses to the risen Lord, revealing his presence in our acts of mercy and love and bringing his healing touch to those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those who are in authority, that they may pursue justice, right the wrongs that persist, and lift up those who are oppressed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who are ill, are imprisoned, homeless, or neglected, that they and those who care for them may recognize the Lord in each other. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our donors, ministries, families, children, the elderly, and the unemployed, that the Lord will see to their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for our intentions and the intentions of more than 80 families that celebrate this Mass with us. Let us pray in a special way for everyone around us that have great seeds, the seeds of faith, or that they may not have seeds of faith, that God may either make these seeds grow or plant seeds in the people that we love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for vocations. Jesus, our Savior, your Sacred Heart felt compassion when you looked upon the crowd and saw that they were like sheep without a shepherd. We know that the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So we ask you, the Master of the harvest, to send out more laborers. Open my heart and the hearts of my brothers and sisters to your will. Raise up joyful young men and women who are open to grow in holiness and devotion and spend themselves for your people in the Diocese of Austin as nuns, sisters, monks, brothers, friars, permanent deacons and priests. May no one in your flock won at the price of your blood be without a shepherd to guide them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to take a moment to prepare our offerings today. Father, we thank you for the great gift of Jesus that has encountered us on the way as we process to leave our offerings at your altar. We ask that you please accept them through Christ our Lord. Accept these offerings that your holy church has brought here today in faith and devotion. To every person that has approached your altar today, please give them your peace and your Easter joy through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant us also the gifts, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is really right and just our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this season above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through Christ, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful, for his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, with Joe our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and the sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, See, more and more I see that sometimes when parishioners cannot receive Holy Communion, you just stay in your pews, but keep in mind that what we want to is, if, even in the case that you cannot receive communion today, just approach the Blessed Sacrament, cross your arms and bow before the presence of the Lord. Don't stay in your pews, just come up, even if you can't receive, that's okay. I mean, it's not okay, but it is okay to approach the Lord and to receive a blessing from the Lord. Don't stay in your pews, if you would please.
If you cannot receive Holy Communion today, please say this prayer with me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
sisters that are homebound or ill in the hospital. May God's peace abide in their hearts. Christ our Lord. Bring peace, Mary. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your holy people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amigos y amigas, mi nombre es Katherine Angulo, soy la directora del programa Thriving in Ministry Initiatives en el Instituto McGrath de la Universidad de Notre Dame, y de verdad que es un honor muy grande para mí el ser una de las oradoras que van a tener ustedes en esta conferencia de la mujer el sábado 20 de abril en su parroquia, en donde vamos a estar hablando de la belleza del papel de la mujer en traer esta cultura eucarística entre nuestras realidades de la familia, de la desde la mesa del altar hasta la mesa del hogar. En mi charla en particular vamos a estar hablando un poco de cómo como mujeres podemos tomar esa corresponsabilidad de nuestro bautismo para traer, imponer en vivo la cultura eucarística en nuestras parroquias y en la comunidad de la gente con la que vivimos nuestra fe cada domingo. Así que amigos, espero que no se lo pierdan, los quiero ver allá. Que estén muy bien, nos vemos pronto.
Thank you, Tony and the team, for the video. This, if you did not understand, that's okay. It was in Spanish, no French or Latin, just pure Spanish. If you have a girlfriend that speaks Spanish, or you have a wife that speaks Spanish, you're welcome to go get a ticket for her and so that you send her to the, or if you have a friend that you would like to come, even if you don't speak the language, you can always give a gift to your friends and have them come and participate of this Spanish conference. There was some misunderstanding. Sometimes we have here events where people just like the diocese, they love to have their men's conference here every year. And it is something that the diocese prepares and then they come here to put it in, you know, in put it, to put it together. And they come here to unfold that. That's in February. But this isn't something that is coming from another location, another organization. It is San Jose who is hosting, preparing, planning this event. And so it is important that we make an effort to attend. It's about the Eucharist, and we are closing with the year of the Eucharist this year. Why not just give it a try, right? Like I said, if you want to come, that's great. Just go get your ticket, okay? If you get them at the office, you don't have to pay shipping and handling charges. Keep in mind, you have to be bilingual or in Spanish to come, okay? You're welcome to come. Yes, you're welcome to attend. He's becoming more and more bilingual. That's great. Okay, so we also would like to congratulate those of you who celebrate your wedding anniversaries in the month of April. Do we have any April wedding anniversary? There's one here and a few there. That's great. That's great. Congratulations. That's great. That's great. Fabulous. Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. Congratulations. Also, we always want to welcome those of you who may just be visiting. If you are not from San Jose, but you are just visiting, please stand, because we have a gift for you, a small gift, but it is a meaningful gift. Come on. There we go. We have a bunch of guests today. That's great. And over there, that's great. That's great. That's great. Thank you very much for visiting us. Come back and see us again. This slide has to do with some rice bowl boxes that were prepared by the Release Education Program. There were about 60 students that participated. I wish 300 of them would have participated, but it didn't happen this year. However, of those who participated, we displayed them last week, if you remember, and there were three prizes for the third, second, and the first place. The one that got more votes is the one at the center, followed by the one on the right, on your left, I'm sorry, and then the one on your right. So anyway, congratulations to those kids who participated. Let's give them a big hand. They deserve it. Right. At times, this may seem like a game, but there is no game. There is a lot of hunger in the world. There is a lot of poverty in the world. And the rice bowl helps provide at least some sort of relief to people that are in great need, greater needs than we may have here. And so thank you to the children that participated, and thank you to each parent that supported these kids in doing this effort for people that are less privileged than we are. The group of Matachines is selling food to benefit their own ministry. So if you would like to go buy something, go get it. If you are not hungry, that's okay. I am hungry. So go get me something to eat. I'll go pick it up later, okay? That's great. And last but never least, we would like to bless religious items. If you have candles, rosaries, or other things that you would like to have blessed, please stand. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, O Lord. You are the fount and source of every blessing, and you look with delight upon the devout practices of your children. Draw near, we pray, on these your servants, and as they use these symbols of their faith and devotion, grant that they may also strive to be transformed into the likeness of Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. I don't want you to forget to pray for those seeds that you planted, or if you did not plant seeds, I want you to please pray hard that those seeds that you did not plant, that God may plant them and make them flourish. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended, go in peace, alleluia, alleluia. Next time I want everybody to sing, okay? I'm going to have a third collection for those who do not sing. Happy Easter. Regina Celi, laetare, alleluia. Quia quem meruis portare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia.
Ora pro nobis Deum. Alleluia.
And may the souls of our faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.